The lobotomite returns. Our lobotomite. Has Dr. Mobius been denominated into scrap metal and voice module parts as we hoped?
Hello guys, welcome to the stream. Wow. I really don't wanna do the first one. Thank you.
Attention, students. This is the pre-recorded voice of your pre-recorded principal, Dr. Principal Boros. You may know me as the head chief first researcher of Labs Z9 and Z14. There I fought valiantly to preserve Rattlesnake and put it in the husk of another feared predator. Oh, and the tarantula hawk. Can't splice enough, I always say. Especially if you can make a magnificent enough about me. It has come to my attention that many of you seemingly innocent children have been subverted by red propaganda. This is a serious matter, requiring the most serious attention. Can you spell attention? After you have I spell it, death tension. Coming, Pico traitors? Now, I will send vicious cybernetic cyborg dogs through the corridors to weed all you traitors out. They will sniff out which among you have chosen the commie path. Especially you, Betsy Bright, who turned me down to the high school dance so you could smoke with Richie Marcus. All monitors will also be vigilant. Step outside during class, and they'll make sure you make a speedy jump back to your desk. Hold your urine and wait for the proper bathroom break time.
him. It's Chewy Chewy.
Residential test. Wasn't that shut down for some reason?
Do not be alarmed.
Attention, students. This is the pre-recorded voice of your pre-recorded principal, Dr. Principal Boros. of this hated facility. Now it's worse, and see it was corrupted by fraternities and girls. Yuck.
Lawful use of deadly force.
Health, health. Thank you.
Hello. It's nice to meet you. Who can I hide you from today? Stimpak reserves adequate. Medic supplies adequate. Data collection array online. Please use the terminal below to begin Dr. User synchronization. This is the basic stealth test. The robots will be looking for us, but we won't let them find us. Test data processed. Firmware updated to version 1.1. Boot damping sensors online. Cessation of hostilities complete.
Hello, ma'am.
Uh-oh.
Tail locking on. All right, everyone. Might have been a blip.
Cessation of hostilities complete. Looks pretty tough.
Oh,
cessation of hostilities complete. Taking down. one. Right in there.
Don't escape me! You're no match for science!
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, it means I have to go back in there. Shoot. I will wait till the end to do it.
That's all.
Attention students, this is the pre-recorded voice of your pre-recorded principal.
Speaking done, fighting now.
Principal Boros.
Cessation of hostilities complete. Time to fight.
I am lord of this institution, where once, long ago,
that's all.
I was a student here. Now, I am its omnipotent god principal. As I soon will be lord of Big Mountain. Doo-dee-doo. Do you hear that? It is my trumpet of victory.
Ready, steady, fighting.
Place all filthy propaganda books in the incinerator chute in the sink. Especially those with funny pictures of me in them.
lawful use of deadly force is in progress. Citizens notified to be here.
Cessation of hostilities complete. Bet no one has ever been as unnoticed as me. Was that all? Steady. Fighting. Fighting over. Time to fight. That's all.
I feel different. Awake. Alive for the first time ever. What is this strange new world around me? What does it hold in store for a dreamer such as myself?
Freddy's plan.
is the advanced test. Watch out for laser tripwires. They'll ruin our day.
Oh my God.
Who do you think is cuter, Dr. Klein or Dr. Boros? Test data processed. For more updated to version 1.2, Aural Subnet online. This is the expert stealth test. If you thought the lasers were bad, wait till you see the proximity mines. data processed. Firmware updated to version 1.3. Torso fitment synced to user's physiology. This is the robot compliance test. If you sneak up on a robot, you can disable it. It's so easy, even I can't mess up. Too bad, we were spotted by robots. If you go back to
spot me. And I must have off that mine too. It was a mighty close one.
Too bad.
Damn it.
We were spotted by robots.
Thank you.
Too bad. We were spotted by robots. If you go back to the terminal to restart the test, I won't mess up again. This is the robot compliance test. If you sneak up on a robot, you can disable it. It's so easy, even I can't mess up. Test data processed. Firmware updated to version 1.4. Impulse accelerator online.
Yeah, we're not gonna, I mean, I would like to get it done tonight. So that way we can start the next one tomorrow. I think that's probably a better option. Get it done tonight. Hold up, that's not... Alright. Whatever.
You're my best friend forever. Time to fight. Cessation of hostilities complete. Time to fight. Was that all? Time to fight. That's all. This one looks pretty tough. Time to fight.
Thank you.
That's all.
Now what? Now we gotta... Oh my god. Find the upgrades to the other dock sink. Go back there again. I mean, I'd like to get this done tonight. That way I can start the next DLC tomorrow night.
Was that all?
time to deal with all this.
Are we being watched? Time to fight.
Oh my God. Alright, I ain't doing this. This is gonna take wait. This is gonna take forever to do.
Bad guys dealt with.
Retrieve the technologies yet? We need them, as I have indicated. Why, yes, we are filled. If you wish to know more. What? You did? Your survival, let alone success, barely registered in my projections. Now, all I need to do is check my transmission data bank. Mobius is always filling it up with his psychotic calls. Oh yes, there's the schematics, just like you said. How truthful. Yes, yes. Yes, yes, No, I mean yes. You just need to analyze these technologies for a moment. They are extremely advanced, you know? I know how these technologies work. Of course I know. If you remember, we described them in clearly abstract, contradictory statements before. Why would we do that if we weren't certain on how to use them? Yes, so let me... a bit, huh? I'll figure it out. Yes, that's what I believe I said. I've got it. The cardiac regulator in the suit, the antenna for brain waves, and the sonic frequency for the vertebral nerves. I'm thinking. This is all very complicated. Let me check something. Of course, I have it. The override sequence to open the Forbidden Zone door is hidden in the schematics. Well, not hidden. It's actually right there, behind the programming equivalent of coffee stains. It's embedded in what seems to be recursive code. It's badly commented there and there. Oh, and null pointers. Very sloppy, Mobius. You see, using the antenna to boost the emitter's sonic frequency, and the stealth suit to bypass the Forbidden Zone lock, yes, that could work. Was that my plan? It must have been. Sometimes I truly surprise myself. The door is open, and now Mobius will get his. Biological? Ridiculous. I mean, technically, these items could all be used to put you back together once you had your brain. But for now, they can be used in the name of aggression. The door should be unsealed. Now, instead of being subjected to threats, and that message is science, deliver this message, and Big Mountain shall be freed from Mobius's reign of terror. You can go now. That's your cue.
The haps. Right on. Was the haps.
It's not like I haven't.
Might I be of service?
To get along with her. Lord knows I have. She's just such a pussy.
This one looks pretty tough.
Might I be of service? Might I be of service?
was the haps. You require some additional services? You require some additional...
Time to fight. Cessation of hostilities. Time to fight.
Pre-recorded
attack message indicating my desire to commit violence on you. I bet no one has ever been as unnoticed as me. Cessation of hostilities complete. Technically, it's impossible to overdose on painkillers. Ready, steady, fighty. Was that all?
Some kind of emergency test shutdown. In five, I'm imagining all sorts of imaginary numbers right now. Oh, hello there. You are there, aren't you? Forgive my confusion. So hard to tell these days. You seem familiar somehow. I'm guessing you're here for your brain, perhaps? It's just up there. Such a nice brain, young, very bright. Little hard to see you. Can you walk into my left, right FOV cone? Ah, that's it. You're coming into focus nicely. Depth perception is a problem with this old monitor of mine. Went black a while ago. That's old age for you. Should look at getting the visual nerves reattached. It's just that the right eye would see the wrong things. Flying tortoises were the worst. Would you care for a Mentat? I have all sorts of amazingly science-erific thoughts and ideas. I forget them all. Had to start. Really? That implies preconceived notions, theories, and a hypothesis. Do you? And does it? The ghosts aren't real? That changes. Please be my guest. Oh. Oh, I was
dragged themselves in out of the wasteland. And where have we been? Crawling through pits of radioactive... I'm not...
If I recall, I had a plan that was working, or whatever it was. I wasn't trying to kill them, just... Blast! I probably... That will be difficult. It would be like fighting five scaled-down versions of me that have better depth perception. And they have an arsenal of vivisectors, brainial beams, and a rather nasty... ray that can make your atoms do a happy dance. If you could survive those highly improbable odds and ends, then deceasing them is definitely an option. Although, I doubt killing them would do anything except make you feel better. Something ingenious and needlessly... I forgot I had... Well, you could try and appeal to their humanity. That's a tired cliché. And really, when they were humans, they weren't very good humans. Well, there's much a wise... Or... Then you came along. Oh, tell them I'm still alive.
Starting combat. Just kidding.
The lobotomite returns. Our lobotomite. Has Dr. Mobius been denominated into scrap metal and voice module parts, as we hoped? I recommend watching your tone with me, lobotomite. Now, your brain. Hand it over, or we'll extract it again. And what could we possibly have to speak about? You have the brain, we have the technology. All you must do is surrender. With it, we can finally leave this place. I cannot tell you how boring this place gets, chopping up the landscape and everything in it. And we have so many questions to ask your brain first. About this Mojave place. First time. That is the most insane thing I've ever heard. There's no way Mobius would condescend to step inside you. Besides, there's no way such a thing could be accomplished. It's impossible. You speak the truth, and the decibel variation in your voice, it is Mobius. How dare you breach the think tank? And what do you want here? That's no deal at all. There's a whole world beyond the crater, filled with ideas and possibilities. We could have escaped, seen it all for ourselves, tested it, prodded at it, made it squirm. Partner with you, my foe, my rival, my foremost critic? I have a strange sensation that I would like that. How odd. Very well, partner. The think tank is at your service as long as you do not destroy us.
As it had been in the years before the Great War, Big Mountain, the Big Empty, became home to one of the brightest minds of the 23rd century. The Courier watched over the Big Empty for years to come, caring for it and keeping its discoveries safe until they were needed to help others. Which had always been Big Mountain's purpose. Past the laboratories and science, it had always been intended as a place to build the future of all mankind.
The Courier had scoured much of the Big Empty, although secrets still remained in the crater's depths. Perhaps that was for the best, however. Curiosity, while sometimes rewarded for its efforts, often proves to be equally dangerous.
Dr. Mobius continued his research undisturbed in the Forbidden Zone. As much as he had attempted to create better scorpions, he tried the same with humanity, with considerably less success. These failures didn't bother him overmuch. Once the rush of Mentats wore off, he forgot he had failed in any event. After all, the bright young mind who had come to visit him in the Forbidden Zone had already exceeded his expectations.
The sink atop the dome bustled with the voices of a small town, constantly chirping, arguing, and snarling at each other. Still, this all happened productively in the interests of its new owner. The sink Central Intelligence Unit discovered, despite its inversion code, it was comforted by the sense of community the other personalities gave it.
The biological research station, obsessed with seeding everything in sight, requested a transfer to the X-22 Botanical Garden, so that it might, in its own words, sensually fertilize the garden's smooth contours. The garden sent back a polite refusal, saying it had prior commitments with a vault it had helped infect before the war.
The Bookshoot continued to devour all seditious materials until it nearly choked on a paperclip. It adamantly maintained it was a Chinese paperclip, and the whole thing had been an elaborately orchestrated assassination attempt. Reason: it slowed down for a while, carefully appraising each document and clipboard that came to it.
The light switches continued to bicker and flicker.
This persisted until the day someone dropped a flashlight in the sink, and the two of them united in their hatred of the showboat.
The sink continued to ruthlessly scrub any particulate matter that came near it. Eventually, it gained access to the magnetohydraulics plant and nearly flooded all the Big Empty in an attempt to scrub the crater clean.
The toaster continued its psychotic spree, reducing all appliances in range to scrap electronics and spare parts. After one of its more psychotic episodes, however, the other sink personalities decided enough was enough and dumped the toaster in a bathtub. Sparking and hissing, the toaster swore its enemies would rue the day when they had bread and no way to toast it.
Muggy did his best to collect coffee cups, although in his quest, he accidentally trapped himself in Higgs Village. It might have been the end for poor Muggy. Except, he found it peaceful there, tidying up the kitchens of the think tank professors back when they had been flesh and bone. Well, except for Dr. O, who was an asshole for having created Muggy in the first place. Muggy left O's house deliberately dirty, punishing the dishes and cups that lived there in blind revenge for serving Dr. O.
Blind I.O. Jefferson eventually discovered a new sound. Silence. It only made him more filled with the blues than before. It was rumored by the other personalities that he had a brief fling with the light switches. Although he forgot their names once too often and was soon left in the dark as punishment.
Autodoc, always gentle and methodical, kept sewing up the courier in all the right places when the skin split open from repeated wear and tear. The Autodoc was just glad to have purpose again. It heard its simpler brothers and sisters who got shipped to the Sierra Madre bored out of their skulls in that toxic, dead city. In time, the Autodoc found a way to deactivate the Y-17 trauma harnesses, releasing the corpses they had held prisoner for almost 200 years.
As the courier ran through the X-8 facility multiple times, the computers analyzed the test subjects' movements. Rather than performing a superficial observation, they realized the subject barely knew what communism was, or even what a high school was. This confused them for a time, until the facility finally realized that its research had succeeded. So it let its cyber dogs out into the wastes to help protect small communities from physical aggression rather than communist propaganda.
The infiltration program in X-13 felt spent, having repeatedly upgraded the stealth suit until it could upgrade it no more. It felt warm, fulfilled, and a bit sluggish. It realized not long after, the stealth suit had left it without so much as a note on the nightstand. So the infiltration program sent out robo-brains into the wastes, looking for its wayward technology. It eventually found Repcon HQ and set up a new research center, testing and murdering fiends who kept breaking into the facility.
The courier, organs intact, continued onwards, a little less heavy of step, but with all the organs in the right places, as they should be. After all, brains can develop a life of their own when left to their own thoughts, and the courier's brain was more clever than most.
Dr. Klein and the think tank remained alive, unaware of the world outside. They looped through their daily routine, none the wiser about the world beyond. Although perhaps wiser was the wrong word. The world outside belonged to the courier. And if anyone would shape it, well, the courier had already called dibs.
There is an expression in the wasteland, old world blues.
It refers to those so obsessed with the past, they can't see the present, much less the future, for what it is.
They stare into the what was, eyes like pilot lights, guttering and spent, as the realities of their world continue on around them.
Science is a long, steady progression into the future. What may seem a sudden event often isn't felt for years, even centuries to come.
In the times following the Second Battle of Hoover Dam, however, Old World Blues took on a new meaning.
Where once it was viewed as a form of sadness, nostalgia, it became an expression describing the potential for the future.
It can be easy to see science as evil, technology unchecked as the source of all ills, all misfortunes.
With the Courier at the helm, science became a beacon for the future. There was Old World Blues and New World Hope. And hope ruled the day at Big Mountain.
We could say more, but the stories in the Big Empty speak for themselves. Now armed with the transportal Ponder, the Courier could return to the dome at any time and crack open the secrets of the Big Empty one by one. The Sink sat vigilant, waiting for its master to return, shoes covered in Mojave dust. Only one road yet remained, and it was one the Courier had to walk alone.
All right, guys.